kicked off against that formidable cup team Blackpool in the quarterfinal on the Seasiders ground, Luton in white shirts. Most of the 30,000 spectators very much fancied Blackpool for Wembley, and their centre-forward Charnley had a good try in the first minute. Bainham cleared, and at the other end, Luton's brilliant outside right Bingham soon had the ball in the danger zone. Blackpool had a very narrow escape when a Luton centre drew Farm out of position and the ball went behind. Stanley Matthews was below his best. Indeed, Blackpool's famous forward line never really clicked. Their outside left Perry put the ball across to Matthews, but Bainham wasn't seriously tested. There was no score at half-time. Blackpool attacked again, but it was the same story as in the first half. Their finishing was too weak to produce a goal. Blackpool tried once more, and this time only Bainham's brilliance kept the ball out of the Luton net. It began to look as if the game might result in a goalless draw. There were only 6 minutes to go. And then Luton strongly attacked. A good centre put the ball under the head of Bingham. Farm was unsighted. Goal for Luton. When the final whistle was due at any second, left-back Hawks passed back to Bainham, only for Charnley to nip in and equalise. So it was a very jubilant Blackpool and a downcast Luton at the end of the match. The home side were lucky to earn a one-all draw.